A very good morning, students. Children, as you know, we have already started with the chapter number 8, Animals Everywhere. We were in the animal kingdom. I have a book in front with me and I just want to show you some pictures of animal kingdom. There, it is really, children, it's vast kingdom. There is no end to the different types of animals. Different mammals, the world of mammals, the lemurs and monkeys, the apes, the cat family, you all know the cat family, lion, leopard, big cats, tigers, lions, leopards, cheetah, the dog family, you have the wolf and the dogs, bears, polar bear, small cunning animals are your foxes, then you have the animals that live in burrows, then insect eating mammals, then you have the rodents which we have studied. The rodents are those squirrels, the rats, the mice, and the rabbits. You have flying mammals that are the bats. Then you have this mighty elephants on the hoof, animals on their hooves that move on their hooves like horses. Cattle family, you have those buffaloes. Then the horse family, zebra and horses, they do the giants, the giraffes, the camels, the rhinoceros, then the water mammal. There is plenty of ocean giants, the shark and the whale, the bird, the birds, they move on their wings, flying, world of birds. Okay, so this animal kingdom is really vast. Now we studied about that how the different animals breathe with their lungs or gills or with their moist skin or spiracles. Different type of animals breathe in different way. We also studied that different animals have different feeding habit. What type of food they eat, it depends on. Now coming to the next topic is animals' movement. As you know, animals move from one place to another. We also move, isn't it? From one place to another for different reasons. Now, what are the different reasons why we move? Now, animals need to move in search of food. Without food, it cannot live. Food and water. So, in search of food and water, animals need to move from one place to another. You can see that we also go in search of food. We go to the market to buy the food. They go to their places where they can get it. They are herbivorous animal, they will search for their plants and other products which they get from the plants and trees. If they are carnivores, they will go out for hunting. So, if they are animals living in water they find the worms and the other small animals. So, in this way, or even the birds, they search for grains, or if they are like crows or eagle and vulture, they will search for even worms and smaller animals. So, in search of food and water, they next is they protect themselves and their babies from being hunted. Naturally, self-guard, they have to save themselves. Even we also, we live in a home where we close our doors at night so that we are protected. So, similarly, if you watch the animal kingdom in your Animal Planet or geographical channels, you will see how animals, the bigger one hunts the bigger ones, they hunt the smaller animals, and the smaller animals, they run, they try to save their lives from this. So it is like a, you know, food, you know, the food chain. So in this way, animals and their babies, animals when their babies are small, they carry their babies with them, and they do, they of course have to save their lives from other animals, from or maybe even human beings also. from getting hunted. I'm not talking about only big animals, even the birds, even the small reptiles or insects, everybody get protectors. Even you must have seen, if you want to kill the mosquitoes, they fly out. They will not try to, they will try to protect themselves. Next is breeding resting places, means their homes, whatever homes. If they are living in trees, homes, and birds build their nest, and you can see animals, the burrows, and different animals, they will, they move for building their resting place where they can rest. Breeding places where they can give their, they can, means you can produce their young ones. Naturally, animals, they produce their young ones, either they give birth to babies or they lay their eggs. So in this way they have breeding place. You must have seen birds, they build their nest and they lay their eggs and they protect their eggs. Even crocodiles, you must have seen, they can even kill human beings if they feel that their eggs are being means they are in danger, or maybe the animal, other animals or human beings are trying to take away their eggs. So in this way animals move from one place to another. Animals use different body parts to move from one place to another. Different body parts. This is what we are going to study in the coming modules, that different animals use different parts of the body to move from one place to another in search of food, to protect themselves and their babies from getting hunted, then they for building their resting place, and for breeding or giving birth to their babies or laying eggs. Okay, so this coming modules we are going to study all these things. Thank you, children.